Reaper, we keep it rough, we keep it raw, we keep it real. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper, cause we doing good things here at Reaper. Kevin Hart slaps Corey Holcomb in the face with picking Wesley Snipes to be in a comedic role with him. Kevin Hart once again disses Corey Holcomb. Corey is always brown-nosing Kevin Hart, saying that's his friend, he's not going to talk about him, he got him a check and everything. And Kevin don't fuck with you. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000, because he know you a garbage-ass, piece-of-shit-ass comedian. You know, this is why Kevin Hart don't mess with you, because he knows that you dysfunctional and you full of chaos. And nobody wants you around, Corey. The Reaper keep it 1,000, you know. But you a play to the hood, like you got your shit going on, and you a good comedian, and you know, you at the top of the food chain, and you one of the best ones out there. But if that's true, why nobody picks you up? You know, if you one of the best ones out there. I told you, brother, you ain't universal. The Reaper keep it 1,000, because Wesley Snipes is not even known as a comedian. I know he played in a comedian role in Tu Wong Fu, you know, long time ago. But Wesley's not really known, you know, as a comedian, you know. And Kevin Hart picked him. And he just didn't pick him for his name or whatever, you know. He picked Wesley because Wesley is a good actor or whatever. But Corey Holcomb could have easily fit into that role. And Kevin Hart's got, you know, comedy shows. He's got movies and all of this. And he never reaches back to give Corey Holcomb a shot. But Corey claims that, you know, they're friends. He don't fuck with you. You know, Corey Holcomb is over the hill compared to Kevin Hart and the rest of these guys, you know. A lot of comedians, you know, is broke or whatever, you know. I mean, only the top flight ones, you know, have money, really, you know. The Reaper keep it 1,000. That's why a lot of these guys go on the road. A lot of these guys, you know, they have illegitimate kids and, you know, they get divorced or whatever. And they're forced to stay out on the road like Corey is, you know, just to earn a buck. But Corey is old for the game. His career is toast. If he hasn't made it now, he'll never make it. I know he was in a few sitcoms and appearances or whatever. You know, Black Jesus was the only one of a couple little appearances in sitcoms here and movies that Kevin Hart gave him a lick or whatever. But Corey really has never got that big break, you know, that he wants. And don't fool yourself, Corey would sell out for it. It's just that nobody fucks with Corey because Corey's a backstabbing piece of shit. The Reaper keep it 1,000. That's why nobody fucks with Corey. Corey was the oldest nigga on Wildin' Out, you know, till Nick Cannon said, oh man, I ain't fucking with this old ass nigga. You know, that's unfunny, that's corny or whatever. Corey sitting up there with the kids on Wildin' Out because he needed a lick, it needed a paycheck, and he the oldest nigga. He 50-something years old, everybody else is 30-something on there, you know. And Corey sitting on there cracking kids' jokes with them or whatever because he need a lick so bad. And he'll never get it or whatever because don't nobody want to mess with you. So go back to your old broad, you know, Darlene, and keep messing, you know, with the drunk singing nigga, you know, that looks like he's out of his mind. The Reaper keep it 1,000, that just be babbling out of control like a old drunk or whatever. You know, what kind of nigga would sit up there in a Halloween costume the whole show or whatever, drinking Patron? You know this nigga is dysfunctional and got some serious issues going on with him. The Reaper keep it 1,000, but Corey wants us to buy that, you know, these niggas is talented or whatever, and that he got his shit going on. And Corey will be on those Where Are They Now, you know, you know, shows or whatever. Whatever happened to Corey Holcomb or whatever, and he'll be living up under a bridge with a piece of newspaper talking about, I was funny at one time. I was at the top of the food chain. He's going to be like that bum, you know, that Damon Wayans play. You know, everybody what I'm saying? Nigga, you on your way out. So you can talk about the Reaper much as you want to or whatever, and what I do for a living. But nigga, you will be living up under a bridge with a TV in a box, just like that bum Damon Wayans do. Reaper, we keep it rough, we keep it raw, we keep it real. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper, because I'm doing good things here at Reaper. Reaper out. Peace.